A popular real-life application dealing with percentages is where you have the price of a certain quantity and you mark it up a certain percentage or you mark it down a certain percentage. And we see this all the time in real life. If you have an item and it's on sale 20%, what you're doing is you're marking the price of the item down a certain percentage. Or you might take a certain amount and mark it up a certain percentage. And there's a way that we can do this mathematically. So let's look at these two formulas, and you'll notice that they're actually pretty similar, marking something up versus marking something down. All right, to do a percent increase, here's what we do. Our new amount is going to be our original amount plus the what we'll call the markup. All right, so this part back here is called the markup. It's a percentage of the original amount, but this is important. It's going to be added back on top of the original amount. A lot of students will forget this first part to add in the original amount, but then the new amount will be smaller than the original amount. If you just take a percentage of the original amount, it won't be higher, it won't be an increase in the original amount, it'll just be just a percentage of the original amount. But if you take that percentage and you add it back on top of the original, you're taking your original price up. Now, on the flip side, you'll notice that to decrease the price is just exactly the opposite. Your new amount would be your original amount minus a percentage of the original amount. So you have to read from the context of the problem, whether it's an increase or a decrease, to know whether you're going to add or subtract. Because if you just see 20% or something like that, that doesn't automatically tell you if you should be adding an amount to the original price or subtracting, but the context of the problem should tell you that. All right, so let's look at one example to kind of illustrate this. So here we have a new TV that was originally priced at $780 is on sale. Okay, when things go on sale, they'll go down in price. So this sounds like a discount. So on sale with a 30% discount, we can take off 30% of the original price. What is the new price of the TV? So let's see if we can do that based off of those formulas on the last page. So our new price will be our original price of $780, either plus or minus a certain amount. Now, since this is a discount, we're going to take some money off of 780. How much are we going to take off? We're going to take off 30% of 780. 780 is your original amount. Now, it's very important when you're dealing with percentages in real life problems, it's imperative that we write this as a decimal. It'll always be given as a percentage in the problem, but we will have to change it into a decimal. So we'll move this decimal place two places to the left, and we'll say 0.30 times 780. And so that's a percentage of the original price that will be taken off of the original price. Okay, so we'll have 780 minus 0.3 times 780. And so you could either go to your calculator and do all this at once, but we'll do it line by line, and that's okay. We'll just do it item by item. 0.3 times 780. So 780, 30% of that would be a discount of $234. So we're going to take off $234 as opposed to adding an additional $234 if it had been a markup. So last step, we'll take 780 minus $234, and the new price would be $546 after the 30% discount. Now, I did this step by step. You could have just typed that equation in all at once and it might have been a little quicker. But in any case, our final answer is, what was it? 540, sorry, said it right, wrote it wrong. $546 is the new price of the TV.